able to come for one reason or the other, but you have tuned in. We are so very glad that you are watching. Welcome to the service, welcome to the presence of the Lord. For the sake of those who are joining us on live stream, I'd like us to just stand and say a prayer as we continue with this service. Father, in Jesus' name, we want to pray for every person joining us over live stream, joining us over the recording of this service from all over the world, Israel, Nigeria, the state. Father, Lord, here in Kenya, all over Nairobi, and all over this country. Father, right now, in Jesus' name, we want to pray that you would bind our hearts together as one, because we are the church of Christ. Lord, not the building, but the people all over the world who are joining together right now to worship you and exalt you. Pray that you shall make us of one mind. Pray that as your presence, Lord, permeates this sanctuary, your presence will permeate every living room, every bedroom, every vehicle, every place that someone is joining us from right now. In the name of Jesus, we desire to experience your presence in a special way. Have your way today. Come on, let's celebrate the Lord in this last day. Hallelujah! Welcome, friends and worship team. Let's praise, let's have church that day. Amen.
Buona sera. Praise God. Are you glad to be back, church? Makofi, makofi, shalom.
Yeah.
good. What a joy. What a pleasure it is to worship the Lord in the beauty of His holiness, to worship in spirit and in truth. Friends, I want to let you know that these are the days that Joel talked about, that the Spirit of God has been poured out. Amen. And that we shall worship in spirit and in truth. Praise the name of the Lord. If you can see there is a wave, there's something happening at St. Mary's Church. I want to let you know it is not just in St. Mary's Church. It is all over the world in the Church of Christ. And I want to let you know this is not hysteria. This is not emotion. This is not people who are just stressed and are looking for a way to let that stress go. This is the end times when the Spirit of God is being poured out. And I dare you to choose to be part of it. Praise the name of the Lord. This morning, this beautiful morning, when we have these people who have come into the house of the Lord responding with such short notice because you were just excited and ready. And with those who are joining us all over the world, Kina SK in Israel, Brother Sam in Nigeria, Sister Daktari Nyamuru, Sister Basilica in the other side of the country, and all those people who are joining us in Nairobi, we want to welcome you one more time because we are so excited. And several of us who are watching us in the States right now, and we want to just thank God that you're joining us. We're going to share today on a topic entitled Peace Like a River. Please share the service, interact with us, start a watch party. Let us get blessed together. Peace like a river. There once was a king who offered a prize to the artist who would paint the best picture of peace. Now many artists tried, because this was a big prize. Many artists tried. And after the king had gone through each and every of the painting, the king looked at all the pictures, went back and forth, and two pictures stood out to him. And so he sort of selected the two to sort of be the final consideration. Of the two pictures, one was of a calm lake, calm blue lake. The lake was a perfect mirror of a peaceful, towering green mountain all around it. And overhead was a blue sky with fluffy white clouds, and the sun was shining. And everything about this picture just made you feel good. Everything about this picture made you relax and feel calm and be at peace. Truly, this was a picture of peace. The other picture had mountains, but not like the other ones. I got an opportunity many years ago to fly over the Rocky Mountains. And I'm telling you, they deserve the name Rocky Mountains, because there were just nothing but rocks jutting up into the sky. It was rather scary because it seemed like we were flying pretty close to the, you know, to the edges of the rocks. This was a rocky, bare, rugged mountain. Above was an angry sky, loud and thundering with lightning. You know, there's a way a picture can speak when it felt loud with thunder. And the sky was dark and it was pouring. Down the side of the mountain tumbled a foaming waterfall. You know, a steep, angry waterfall. You could see from the color of the water that this water was just rolling down, vigorously, angrily, unfriendly. This did not look peaceful at all. But when the king looked closer, he saw behind the angry waterfall, he saw a tiny bush. And in that bush, with the angry, loud waters thundering past, he saw a mother bird sitting on her nest on that small bush in the midst of that bare rock. And that mother bird, in spite of the loud waters and the thunder and lightning, was peacefully seated, nestled comfortably, cozily in her nest. A picture of perfect peace. You know what? The king chose a second picture. And this was the explanation he gave. He said this: peace does not mean being in a place where there is no noise or trouble. No. Peace does not mean being in a place where everything is easy and relaxed and there's no work. Peace means being in the midst of all these things and still being calm in your heart. That is the real meaning of peace. Wouldn't it be nice to have peace today? Wouldn't it be nice to just close your eyes and be alone in your heart and feel not scattered and not hectic and not hurried and not stretched, neither stressed, but rather just calm and solid and centered and just to feel okay and well? Wouldn't it be great to wake up in the morning and just smile and welcome the day ahead, because there's a deep in your soul, there's a sense of peace with yourself and with your life. Wouldn't it be great to have something difficult or painful come plunging at you and yet still not react with panic or dread or fear, but rather calm assurance? And whatever the problem is, God's got your back. That you know God and God's going to take care of you. That's peace. God will bring you out of it. Wouldn't it be great to really, truly, honestly be at peace? Well, this morning I have good news. Hallelujah. This morning I have good news that peace is attainable. This peace from the Prince of Peace. This is the peace that Jesus came to bring. And this is what God promises will be our experience if we will walk with Jesus and allow Him to be the Savior and the Lord of our lives. I want to read our New Testament scripture. We read the Old Testament reading. I want to read the New Testament. I want to just read one verse. Romans 15:13. The Bible says this. Romans 15:13. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust Him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace, so as you trust Him, that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Friends, I think it is safe to say that all of us want to be joyful. All of us want to be happy, right? Everybody wants to be happy. And that's the target of everyone. You start your day and you want it to be a good day. You want to be joyful, you want to be happy. But can I submit to you that it is impossible to be happy without peace? It is impossible to be joyful without peace. Praise the Lord. Right, it is impossible. I think it is safe to say that if you want happiness, if you want joy in your heart, we use this in that song in Sunday school. If you want joy in your heart, you have got to start with peace. But you know what? The challenging thing, the interesting thing about peace is that it seems to be so fleeting. It seems to be in such short supply. It seems like what we see around us is despair and despondency and desolation and depression running wild and uninhibited around us. When you listen to the news, when you watch social media, when you look at things all over around, there doesn't seem to be such a good supply of peace. You think about our neighborhoods, our schools, our politics, our churches, our markets, our families. There just doesn't seem, if you look at the news, to be so much peace in our lives. You look at our neighborhoods. Yesterday, we were driving along a road somewhere, a very posh estate, and there was somebody who called a big one ghetto. Right? Right in the middle of a driveway in the poshest estate. Yeah, struggling for his life, about to lose his wallet and so forth. There is no peace in our neighborhoods. There's no peace in our churches. You hear of church divisions, of certain churches about to go up and bank up. Hello, I don't see anyone from that neck of the woods where they do that. Maybe you're watching me. Unasikia ati, oh, this church has split and they come with bankers in church. Fanya fujo. You know, there is no peace in our churches. There's no peace in our schools. We talk about dorms being burnt every day. People, children going on strike. There is no peace in our markets and our families and so on. When you watch the news, you know, I go to a place, I just don't watch the news. For my peace. It's important to watch the news. You don't have to follow me. I choose and pick what to watch and what to listen to. Because when you look at the news, you will be so disturbed. It begins with a little child being defiled, to a woman being cut up into pieces and the pieces cannot be found, right? To I don't know who shot who and where. I mean, by the end of the news, you are depressed. For God forbid that you should be alone watching those news. You know, thank God for those who have family, that you can crack a joke and laugh and try to forget, right? But it's so depressing. I personally just stay away and pick and choose what to find out where. I mean, I want to be very specific about what I want to know. Because when you listen to the news, there's no peace in our churches, in our families, in our politics, in our government, in our nation. There's just no peace. And I suspect the media companies believe that peace doesn't sell. And so peace doesn't sell newspaper. Peace doesn't sell, you know, whatever, the bills they need to pay, and so forth. And so they ensure that it's bad news everywhere. Now, I'm not one who has ever indulged in the bottle. But from those who do that, I hear there's a time that is called happy hour in the bars, right? Yes, so I hear. But you know, when I go around to Moine and the bars that are here, or when I'm around Westlands and I pass those very famous pubs I hear about, I don't see happy people coming in and going out of happy hour. It just seems people who are stressed and desperate to get a bottle and get over the stresses of their lives, or just desperate to get drunk and talk to any stranger about their problems. That doesn't sound like happy hour to me. I want to tell you, even though each and every one of us wants to be happy and wants to be at peace, there just doesn't seem to be enough supply of peace. I mean, in our country right now, domestic abuse is an understatement with what we see every day. I think, folks, it's time for us to rediscover peace. It's time for us to look for peace. It's time for us to pray for peace. It's time for us to rediscover peace in our hearts, in our lives. I am a fan of looking at surveys. And one of the survey questions that appears in most psychological surveys is, if you could ask for one thing in the world, what would it be? And of course, you would imagine, if I could ask for one thing in the world, I would want to be married to Jennifer Lopez or Ruiz. Not me, by the way, Ruiz, if you're watching. Now I'm thinking about what people do. Yeah, I'd like to be married. Who are the hottest looking celebrities? I don't keep up with these things. If you could have one thing in the world, I'd like to be married. But who are the good looking men? Maybe I have ladies around me. Who are the good looking men in Hollywood? Yeah, I'd like to be married to Denzel. Denzel is now an old man. But I'd like to be married to Denzel, right? Or you would even say, I'd want to have $100 million. But you know the most common answer to that question is, I just want to have peace. Do you know the guys at happy hour, they're just going to look for peace. Strangely, if you could get one thing in the world, people just want peace. Amani too. Peace is everything, is what everyone wants. And yet it seems that very few people find it in this journey of life. And very few seek to cultivate it. Mother Teresa said, if you want peace, go home and love your family. Mother Teresa said that. Listen to a couple of passages of scriptures that speak about what to do to get peace. Proverbs 16:7, the Bible says, when a man's ways please the Lord, he makes even his enemies to be at peace with him. Isn't that something? When a man's ways please the Lord, he makes even his enemies to be at peace with you. I mean, even your enemies fall in love with you. Would a man come from chicken? Yeah, he's okay. When a man's ways is right with the Lord, Isaiah 26:3, you will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you. John 14:27, peace I live with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let it be afraid. John 16:33, these things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. Philippians 4:6-7, be anxious for nothing. It would be nice if you could listen to this advice. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guide your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Leviticus 26:6. I will give you peace in the land, and you shall lie down, and none will make you afraid. I will rid the land of evil beasts, and the sword will not go through your land. You know, the greatest need, the greatest longing for human being is peace. The greatest reason for human sickness is lack of peace. Hallelujah. Charles Stanley, a renowned pastor and author, has written a book about finding peace. And in it he states this: remember, what the world offers as peace is ultimately an illusion. Even though it may appear very concrete, it is like a mirage in the desert. A mirage looks like a body of water in the desert, but in fact it does not exist and therefore is never attainable. A mirage has absolutely no ability to quench thirst. The world regards peace as being a byproduct of doing the right deeds, saying the right words, working in the right job, having the right intentions. And these aren't at all the criteria for peace described in God's word. It's a mirage. They say, meditate. And so you cross your leg and you home, I don't know why the home. It's a mirage. That's not peace. The foundation for peace is God. Peace comes from God. That is why the Hebrew Bible calls God Jehovah Shalom. Jehovah our peace. Praise the Lord. Jehovah our peace. In fact, the Bible has more than 300 verses which speak about peace, and we're not going to them right now. But I want to just say a few descriptions about the peace of God that distinguishes it from the peace that the world has to offer. Right? I know a lot of people, during the lockdowns, especially the first lockdown, when things were so depressing and dreary, people looked for love. And so, my goodness, we had a baby boom, haven't we? I mean, babies here, babies there, babies everywhere. What a blessing. And so we have been afraid. When we went to the second lockdown, I started calling parishioners and said, please, it's not time. You're not yet married. Please, wait upon me. If I called you, you are not alone. I called many people. I called brothers as well. And I told them, you know, you don't have to go to look for relationships to have peace. Praise the name of the Lord. Why? Because all that is a mirage. Right now there are people who, I mean, we have seen very famous people who are being described as deadbeat. Yeah? Nafset. Number one, God's peace will transcend your circumstances. God's peace will transcend your circumstances. See, that's why God's peace is so unique. God's peace does not deny reality. It doesn't offer escapism. God's peace does not say there is no corona. God's peace does not say do not wear your mask. No. Instead, God's peace has the sustaining power to help us in the midst of the reality. When people are anxious and panicking, the Lord gives us a sense of God is in control. John 16:33, Jesus told us that when we go through storms in our journey, we will go through storms in our journey, but it is in the journey and it is through the storms of crisis of life that God's presence is most clearly manifested. Can I say that again? Jesus promises us that we will go through storms. In this life we have tribulation, and yet it is in the midst of the crisis that God's presence is clearly manifested. I've had people say, if it wasn't for the Lord on my side, as David, I would not have made it. I wouldn't have pulled through, but because God was with me. So God's peace becomes more alive and felt in the midst of trials and tribulations. Secondly, God's peace will supersede your own understanding. We read from Philippians 4:6-7, where we speak the blessing of the peace of God which passes all understanding. Friend, you see, peace is not something you can figure out or understand. No, it's not. Indeed, a lot of times it is beyond understanding. You find that you have been bereaved. You are supposed to be broken, devastated. But God gives you a sense of acceptance and a sense of peace, knowing that God is in charge and in control. Hallelujah. You have been heartbroken. And everyone expects you to be hiding somewhere in a dark room crying 365 days. And God gives you just a sense of peace in knowing that God's got you in his hand. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God's peace is not something you can figure out or understand. It comes. In fact, I think it is not meant to be understood. It just happens, and it is not meant to be understood. Your attempts just feel at peace and you don't even understand, why am I so peaceful? And you start to try to figure out, oh, the sun has come out finally. No wonder I'm feeling so good. Oh, or maybe, and you know, Brother Mike smiled at me. No. God, the Spirit of God in you is just giving you peace in your circumstance, in your situation. Praise the name of the Lord. They look at you, they try to offend you and wonder, what's up with this sister? You try to offend her. She is just calm and collected and peaceful. Why? Because you don't have to understand it. It's just there. Praise the name of the Lord. God's peace is functional in us. It is operating in us. It is available to us far beyond our ability to understand. Oh, hallelujah. God's promise of peace is a gift beyond compare. You don't have to understand it, but God promises it, and you can ask for it and receive it. I know I'm speaking to somebody today. Praise the name of the Lord. I hope you know that you can receive God's peace today. Number three, God's peace is offered to everyone who wants it. We sing about, you know, I have got peace like a river. When peace like a river turneth my way. Peace is a promise of God. Peace is the result of retraining and renewing of mind. Romans 12, do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Next Saturday, I'll be doing a Zoom class, my first Zoom class. So I've asked Brother Mike to give me a few pointers. And I'll be talking about a positive mind. And do you know, this is where peace begins. Because when you think positive things, I love what Baba Eddie shared on WhatsApp. Attitude is everything. When you think positive things, you get positive emotions, positive vibes, right? Right. So when you look at someone and you always find a reason to be unhappy with them, you always find a reason to think the worst of them, you're always going to have with that an associated negative emotion, right? So the Lord is asking us to renew our mind, to have our minds renewed by the Holy Spirit, Romans 12:2. Do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world. The pattern of this world is negativity, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is. It's good, pleasing, and perfect will. When God gives you peace, you begin to understand things that are beyond your understanding. You know that God's got you covered. You know that God has a good plan for you, even in the midst of the worst of circumstances. God gives you peace and contentment. Are you listening to me? Praise the Lord. It doesn't matter what you're going through today. I want to let you know that God's peace is available to you in spite of your circumstance. God's peace is offered to anyone who wants it. Praise the name of the Lord. Charles Stanley writes in his book that I mentioned earlier. He says, from cover to cover, God's word presents the resounding truth. God wants you to be a peace with Him, and with peace in your heart, have peace with your neighbors as much as it depends on you. The fourth point I'd like us to note about peace as I come to an end is that God's peace is designed to be a state of being. You know, when we face moments of panic and anxiety and fear, that should not be the norm of our lives. Know that people who just be stressed throughout. Yeah, they're stressed throughout. And it becomes the way of life. I've always wondered, I know that there are certain points in my life that I stretched myself, I'd be studying and I'd be working and I'd be living on coffee to the certain extent that I realized my hand was shaking throughout. And I've met people like that, right? You know, you're so stressed, you're so warmed up, that your body is just... Either you're so pumped up on coffee or... And you just... That should not be the norm of our lives. The moments of fear and panic should be an exception. And if you're connected with the Holy Spirit, then the Holy Spirit quickly fills you back with His peace. And so even though peace seems elusive, it is within our grasp. This power of the Holy Spirit within us speaks peace to our hearts and minds. It is God's desire that you and I have an abiding peace at all times. I want to pray for you today. I want to pray that God will give you this peace. It's great when we come to church and we're in our Sunday best and we have put several foundations, for those who do foundations, and we are looking peaceful until you get the makeup off. Right? Until you get the Sunday best off. And then you go back to the misery and the fear and the stress. The Lord doesn't want us to live that way as Christians. Most people lose their peace not because anybody can trigger you, but because you surrender to your crisis. Are you listening to me? You surrender to your crisis. You surrender to your situation. You surrender to your problem. God has promised us a peace that is abiding. And if you choose not to surrender to your situation, to your stress, to your negative thoughts, you will have this peace. Before we pray, there are several other things that we must watch out that steal our peace. Number one, fear. If you give in to fearful thoughts, you lose your peace. Number two, Satan is the author of many of our anxious and fearful thoughts. What if this happens? What if this? And that's why people have nightmares and they wake up screaming at night and people who cannot sleep alone at night. Hello? Satan is an author of those things. And if you surrender to those thoughts, he steals your peace. The Lord wants you today to identify the Satan and, like Jesus said, get thee behind me, Satan, and walk in the darkness without fearing the shadows. Are you listening to me, somebody? God has promised us a peace that you can be a sister, live alone in your apartment without fearing. Yes, that's the kind of peace that God promises, because it is God who takes care of us. Praise the name of the Lord. And having a brother there, you know, you need to be realistic. Having a brother there, will a brother stop a bullet? Come on now. I know, sisters, you like to have a brother to protect you. I mean, nowadays you've got to be realistic. Yes, a brother will be there, and indeed a pastor should get to you over his dead body. But a lot of times brothers take off and they run for their lives. But the point is only God can give security and peace. Praise the name of the Lord. Yes, because you think you have the biggest brother in town, there is a brother who will dwarf that brother. Yes, and if you have the Mr. Kenya on your corner, and then this dwarf comes with a gun and shoots you, Mr. Kenya. Only God can give us peace and security. The other thing that can take away our peace is sin. Unconfessed sin. Unconfessed sin gives the devil a chance to take away our confidence. Right? Unconfessed sin, it'll take away your peace. Remember the story of Kubukakuku. The devil has a way of reminding you your sin. If you want to retain your peace, hallelujah. Finally, number four, when you lose focus of your relationship with God. I know so many people during the lockdown, you may have allowed your relationship with God to lose focus. You have you've not kept up with your prayer life, you've not kept up with your Bible study, with your time of prayer. That can steal your peace. That may be the reason you're not having peace. It is time to go before the Lord and renew your commitment, your relationship with Him. How do we regain peace? Go to God in repentance and petition for peace. And He has promised that He will give us peace. God wants us to know peace. He has promised to provide peace for us. But the choice has to be yours. Choose to live in peace. Be a peacemaker by directing others to the source of peace. Not yoga, right? Not all those other things, but Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace. Shall we start with prayer? Heavenly Father, we are so grateful for the opportunity you've given us to listen to your word. And indeed, there are so many things in this time, times that we're living in, that have swallowed our peace. And we look around in our country, in our nation, in the world today, there is a dearth of peace. There is a shortage of peace. And Lord, we see many reasons for panic and fear. Many are becoming sick with ulcers and high blood pressure and other challenges because psychosomatic challenges because of lack of peace. Father, I want to pray right now because you have promised to give us a peace that is beyond our circumstance. A peace that is beyond our challenge. A peace that is beyond our problem. A peace that is beyond the thing that is bugging us. A peace that passes all understanding. I want to pray for that person right now who is stressed and depressed and is just looking for hope. That today you would shine your light of peace in their heart and in their mind. They don't have to understand how you will do it. Just grant them peace that passes all understanding. Peace that is greater, that is sufficient to this challenge in the mighty name of Jesus. As you stood in Galilee and spoke the words, peace be still, and every storm and every wave, Lord, listen and hearken. I want to pray right now that you will speak into the heart of every person listening and watching this video and listening in church today. But Lord, you will speak peace in our hearts, that we will no longer be scared, we'll no longer be anxious about anything, but in everything we will trust you and we will trust your plan for our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Come on, let someone just celebrate the Lord. Just appreciate the word of God. We want to just take some time and worship the Lord right now as we reciprocate to His word, as we thank God for His peace. And I want to especially pray for those who are worshiping the Lord from home. I know you're getting ready right now to send your gift to Safaricom PayDeal 991740, 991740, Safaricom PayDeal account. You can put offering, you can put fast fruit, you can put fire. I want to pray for you right now as you get ready to worship the Lord with your gifts. And I want to pray that the Lord will bless you as you give this generous contribution right now. The rest of us will get ready to be ushered in. We will be ushered as we come to offer our gifts. I'm looking for the offering bags. Ushers and brothers and sisters, set the offering bags. Please, the altar box is in the middle. We will just come and we will just worship the Lord in our gifts. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we give you praise. We thank you for your peace. Sometimes you don't understand why we are so peaceful in our circumstances. And now we begin to understand it's because you have given us your peace through your Holy Spirit. Sometimes we go through the most tragic situations in life, and you carry us through, and we don't even understand how. And Lord, today we realize that you have promised and offered your peace to every believer. And I want to receive that peace right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And I want to speak your peace to every person right now. Lord, as we prepare to worship you with our gifts, with our tithes, with our offerings, as we send our gifts, our worship gifts, Safaricom PayDeal 991740, as we bring our tithes and offerings right here in church, I pray that each and every one of us that day shall experience and enjoy your peace. I pray that you will bless the labor of our hearts because you have opened an opportunity for the economy to be opened up again, I pray that you will bless the labor of our hearts, bless our businesses, grant us favor at work. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can we move as we get a song to just worship the Lord? I want to invite the praise and worship team. Let's just do a song and just celebrate the Lord as we offer as we give our offering.
Praise Jesus.
Lord, you are eternal. You Show us your mercy, O Lord.
Grant us your salvation.
O Lord, then our president.
Give you wisdom and justice.
May your ministers serve you faithfully.
May your Lord your people joyfully.
In the valley of the shadow of death.
Grant us your glorious
sun. Like trees planted by the waterside.
Grant us the fruit of your spirit.
Send us out as the soul of the earth.
As the light of the power.
May the earth be filled with your glory. Christ our Lord.